morning to all of you children. Today we are going to start fifth poem of our Honeydew book, which is The Schoolboy, written by poet William Blake. Before we start the poem, let me explain you the introduction of the poem. This poem is written by William Blake, where a schoolboy is the speaker. He wakes up as a happy child, but on the thought of going to school and with the thinking of being at school, he becomes very sad, he becomes very unhappy, and he makes a plea to his parents that he should be allowed to live with freedom and with his joyful nature. So class, what's in the poem? Let's start. I'm reading out the poem loudly for you all, and you all have to look at your book, opening the poem, The Schoolboy. On page number 84, let's start the poem. I love to rise in a summer morn when the birds sing on every tree. The distant huntsman winds its horn and the skylark sings with me. Oh, what a sweet company. But to go to school in summer morn, oh, it drives all the joy away. Under the cruel eye outworn, the little ones spend the day in sighing and dismay. Ah, then at times I groping sit and spend my day and spend many anxious hours. Nor in my book can I take delight, nor sit learning's bore, worn through with the dreary shower. How can the bird that is born for joy sit in a cage and sing? How can a child, when fears annoy, but droop his tender wings and forget his youthful spring? O father and mother, if birds are nipped and blossoms blown away, and if the tender plants are stripped of their joy in the springing day by sorrows and cares dismay, how shall the summer rises enjoy or the summer fruits appear? So class, this was the poem written by William Blake. Now I will explain you the poem paragraph wise. Now look at the first paragraph. Here the poet, the schoolboy, the narrator of the poem, the schoolboy describes what happens when he wakes up in the morning. He said that it's a lovely morning and he loves to rise early in the morning on listening the huntsman blowing his trumpet or blowing his horn during the daytime. And he likes to listen to the singing sounds of birds, and the skylark, which is singing along with him, gives him a sweet company. He likes the skylark giving him a sweet company by singing along with the poet, the schoolboy. And he says it's a very lovely company, it's a very lovely morning. And then, but to go to school in the summer morn, but the thought of going to school, but on the idea or on the time of, at the time of going to school, when he remembers that he has to go to school for studies and learning, all his joy, all his morning happiness goes away. All the joy of his life or the morning drives away, and he thinks that whole day he will be under the supervision of his cruel teacher, and he will have to spend the whole day sitting in front of his teachers, listening to the lectures and taking the classes, which are uninteresting and boring, and all the time sitting at school will be spent in very sadness, sudden disappointment, and all his joy will be taken away by the school teachers and the time spent over there sitting in the classroom listening to the lectures of the teachers. Now the third paragraph, then at times I drooping sit. All the time he would sit there uninterestingly, unhappily, with his back bent down like this, and he would have to sit there in tensed pose. He will be very tense sitting over there for many hours, he will not take any interest, he will not take any interest in his books nor in the lessons which are being taught by his teachers. And all the dreary showers, all the things which would happen with him in the school will be cheerless and uninteresting, and it will be very unhappy feelings, unhappy time for him to sit in the school. Then he compares his life with the bird. He says, if a bird which is born to fly would be kept in a cage, how would it sing freely? Means just like the bird, a child is born to enjoy freely, to enjoy the nature with his freedom and play during his childhood. But if he would be sent in school sitting under the supervision of his teachers, he would how enjoy his life? How would he turn up to be a joyful boy in his future? If all his delight, all his joys would be taken away from him right in the childhood. Means if he would not be led to enjoy his childhood during his young days, how would he enjoy his days? How would he come up as a cheerful boy? He says, if we cut the tender wings of the bird, how would it enjoy or how would it sing in the springtime with all his freedom and with his lovely voice? And then the last para, he makes a plea, makes a request to his parents, and he gives them a message that if the birds, before turning into flowers, will be cut or will be plucked, how would they blossom or how would they bloom into bright and colorful flowers? And if the tender plants, which are soft and delicate, would be cut or stripped, which will be forcefully torn out from the soil, how would they grow into beautiful plants, flowery plants in spring season? But it would turn into sadness, and it would make everyone sad, uncheerful, and it would make everyone very unhappy and disappointed if they would not be let to grow freely or let to grow with freedom. It would make everything very unhappy, disappointing. And then, how shall these things which are meant to blossom, which are meant to bloom and spread their fragrance, would give the summer fruits, or which would give the fruits in summer season? So here the poet basically wants to request his parents to let a child enjoy his childhood with freedom and with joy. He says that let a child live his life with freedom and enjoy his childhood days. Don't pressurize a child for going school or for studying. This is the gist of the poem. Now class, what you have to do, I have written some word meanings on the board. You have to copy down these word meanings in your fair notebook. Okay? Copy.